Friends, 12th standard physics. So in this class we are going to discuss about motional EMF from Lorentz force. So consider a rod of length L. So the rod is AB. So it is placed in a uniform magnetic field. So the magnetic field is perpendicular to the rod. So just see. So this is the direction of magnetic field. So magnetic field points inwards. So that is represented by cross. So the magnetic field points inwards. Then the length of the rod is perpendicular to the magnetic field. Now the rod moves towards right, so the magnetic field points inwards, then rod moves in this direction. So the angle between the magnetic field and velocity vector, so the magnetic field and velocity vector is 90 degree. So just see, so this is a plane of paper, so that is, consider this as a rod. So the magnetic field points inwards, then it moves in this direction. So all the three, so the rod, then magnetic field inwards, then the rod moves in this direction. So what is the angle here? It's 90 degree. So the force, that is, there is a magnetic Lorentz force acts on the rod. So that is, the free electron gets moved from B to A, it accumulate on A. So what is the magnetic Lorentz force? That is on free electrons, F is equal to minus E times B cross B. Then there is a magnet, that is a electric field from B to A. So due to the free electron shifted and accumulated at A, so there is a Coulomb force acts from A to B. So Coulomb force F is equal to E times E. Then the free electrons moves, the electric field keep on increasing, Coulomb force value is also keep on increasing. It reaches the equilibrium point. So at equilibrium point, both magnetic force and electric force equal. Then equate the two equations. So you will get minus E V cross B equal to minus E electric field vector. So minus minus cancel, then E cancel. Then, so what is the angle between the velocity vector and magnetic field? So now, so this is a rod. So rod moves in this direction, magnetic field acts in this direction. So what is the angle? So it's 90 degree. So sin 90 equal to 1. So BB. So here B is velocity. Small v we should use. So electric field E equal to velocity times magnetic field. So there is a potential difference across the conductor. So that potential difference V is equal to, so we know electric field V E is equal to potential difference by length. So V is equal to E times L. Just substitute the value of E. So E is equal to velocity into magnetic field. So finally, the potential difference is due to the magnetic Lorentz force. It induces the induced EMF. So induced EMF E is equal to VBL. Here V is the velocity of the conductor, B is the magnetic field, L is the length of the conductor. Now we are connecting with the external circuit. So have a resistance R. So what is the current flowing through the circuit? So current V, according to Ohm's law, V is equal to IR, I is equal to V by R. So here the induced EMF is V, so E by R, so E is equal to BLV by R. So the direction of current is found through the right hand thumb rule. So direction of current, then direction of magnetic field. Now we are going to see one problem regarding this formula. So consider a rod of length 0.5 meter again. So it falls from a height 7.2 meter. So consider a rod 0.5 meter, it falls from a height 7.2 meter. Then there is a uniform, that is horizontal component of its magnetic field acts. So the magnetic field acts in this direction. So the rod moves in this direction. So both are perpendicular to each other. There is a induced EMF produced across the conductor of length 0.5 meter. So we are going to find. So consider the value of G is equal to 10 meter second power minus 2. Then, so what is the velocity? So it reaches the earth, at what velocity it hits the earth? So using the equation of motion, 3 V squared equal to U squared plus 2 G H. So the initial velocity should be, so at initially it is at rest, I am leaving, I am catch. So the U is equal to 0, so V squared equal to 2 G H. Then G is 10, then height H is equal to 7.2 meter. So you will get 7.2, it's 14.4 into 10, it's 144. So V squared equal to 144, V is equal to 12 into 12, 144. So you will get velocity V equal to 12 meters second power minus 2. Then, So what's our aim? We need to find what is the induced EMF developed in the conductor if it is fall from a height 7.2 meter and there is a horizontal magnetic field, that is Earth's horizontal magnetic field value 4.04 into 10 power minus 5 Tesla. So the induced EMF BHLV, just substitute the values. So just 0.5, instead of 0.5 I am using 1 by 2. So 1 by 2, just 1 2 is 2, 6 2 is 12, then 6 into 4.04, just directly will get the answer. 4 6 are 24, again 4 6 are 24, 24.24. Then, so what I am going to do, 24.24 into 10 power minus 1 into 10 power 1. So if you add, you will get 1. So just take it, so it's 242.4 into 10 power minus 1 into 10 power minus 5. So just add those two, you will get 10 power minus 6. So it's microvolt. So 242.4 microvolt is induced in the conductor of length 0.5 meter. If it is fall from a height 7.2 meter, the Earth's horizontal magnetic field 4.04 into 10 power minus 5 Tesla. So similar problem. Here consider again a rod of length L. It is moving in a circular path. So there is a uniform magnetic field. So just see, this is a circle. So it moves in a circle. So the magnetic field acts in this direction. So if it is the conductor moves the velocity and magnetic field perpendicular to each other, there is an induced EMF produced in the conductor. So we are taking a small element dx. So the induced EMF for the small element dx, the dx is from the center x distance. So E is equal to BLV, we know the formula. Then for small, there is an induced EMF for small distance dx. So d epsilon equal to BV dx. Then, so B is a linear velocity. So linear velocity V is equal to R omega. So we have studied in plus 1. So here R is a radius. So it's from the origin O to dx is x distance. So x is a radius here. So instead of R, we need to use x. So BX omega dx. Then, so we are going to find what is the total induced EMF produced in the conductor of length L. So it's from, we need to integrate from 0 to L. So integral D equal to E. Okay, fine. Then 0 to L B omega X dx. So B omega is common, taken out. Then integral X equal to X dx equal to X power N plus 1 by N plus 1. So X squared by 2. Then substitute instead of X, upper limit minus lower limit, you will get 1 by 2 B omega L squared. So in this class we have discussed a problem, two problem with the theory. So that is motional EMF from Lorentz force. So the rod is moving, so the EMF is produced due to the movement of the rod. So it's called motional EMF from Lorentz force. So we have seen one problem, a nice problem, this one, and also that second problem also. So they may ask in 3 marks. So okay students, thank you.